Mr. Speaker.
Ginny Solicitor, 5 minute
question. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. After 9 long years under this National government, have they delivered a better, brighter future for all New Zealanders as they promised? Not for so many of the people in Manukau East, Mr. Speaker. Not for many of the people in South Auckland. The 2017 budget is trying very hard to patch up the huge deficits in housing, in education and in health, Mr. Speaker. My comments will focus on these three areas, but I'll start with housing. After 9 years of failure in housing, Mr. Speaker, does Budget 2017 deliver solutions? Will this budget fix the housing crisis? Does it provide long-term solutions for homelessness, Mr. Speaker? The answer is no, not at all. But how I wish, Mr. Speaker, that it actually addresses housing for so many of our people in a comprehensive way. National's answer in this particular budget, as far as I can see, to the housing crisis, is they will fund land that would build 1,200 homes. But, Mr. Speaker, when Auckland is short by over 40,000 houses right now, when the rest of the country is short by over 25,000 houses, Mr. Speaker, providing funding for land for 1,200 homes will not fix the issue, Mr. Speaker. In this budget of 2017, they also provide accommodation supplement. But, Mr. Speaker, my question is, what are the people that are needing help now going to do between now and April of next year when this accommodation supplement actually kicks in? Last winter, Mr. Speaker, we went through what I would call a winter of misery. So many people who live in garages, working families who live in cars, and Mr. Speaker, there is a huge increase of people who are now living in boarding houses. Just on the Sunday Star Times 2 days ago, Mr. Speaker, we saw and they covered boarding houses in West Auckland. And unfortunately, a boarding house that my office has been working with over the last few weeks in Otahuhu in my electorate at Manukau East. So imagine this, Mr. Speaker, walking up to this particular boarding house. From the outside, it looks like a house that's fine. The fence is pretty tall. So it's not actually until you're close to the house that you see over 90% of the windows have no glass, Mr. Speaker. But when you walk up to this house, what hits one first is the smell that comes out from this house. And what you know from walking into the house is you see black mould, Mr. Speaker. You see a kitchen that doesn't have a stove that works, Mr. Speaker. You see people that live in this particular house that is not fit for people to live in, Mr. Speaker. This is the kind of boarding house that accommodation supplements are paying for. But my question is, Mr. Speaker, what is the current government doing to ensure that the houses that our accommodation supplement pays for are fit and proper and healthy, warm, dry and healthy, for everyone to live in? What we know, Mr. Speaker, is in 2009, we had over 69,000 state houses. We also know that in 2016, we only have 61,600 state houses now, and you add on an extra 2,700 of leased houses. So within 8 years, Mr. Speaker, this government has sold off 7,400 houses. On which planet is it that when we have a housing crisis, when we do not have enough houses, that it is a solution to sell off the state houses, Mr. Speaker? We are a country that usually prides ourselves in serving our families who are the most vulnerable people, Mr. Speaker. But right now, shame on this government. We are not serving our most vulnerable people. We are not ensuring that they're even housed, especially our working families who work full-time, but they cannot afford to pay the rent. They live in cars, they live in garages, and Budget 2017 does not provide a solution for that, Mr. Speaker. Only a change in government would provide a solution. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Paula Bennett.
Well, Mr. Speaker, that member talked about planning.